9:15. I don't know what day. Oh, February 10th, Saturday. Sorry, that kind of happens when you're in college. You kind of just lose track of days. But today is, so I hit chest on Friday. I hit body parts 2 to 3 times a week. But yeah, so anyways, I hit chest on Friday. Saturday I hit back. And today is usually arms and shoulders. So I'll be hitting that. And I'll probably throw some squatting in. Just because I like to squat every day. But we're here on Arnold Blueprint, or on bodybuilding.com. And this is honestly where I first started off. I've come to bodybuilding.com and just look at all these workouts, and you kind of learn how to hit certain body parts, or you kind of see that there's a pattern to all of it. But anyways, I don't know why I can't flip the camera, but yeah, so today's shoulders and arms. So I'll probably be doing a throwback and doing this workout. And also probably, so for triceps, they don't really have one of the things that I like doing, which is close grip bench. So I'll probably throw that in, and forearms and everything like that. So I'll be doing that today. So I'll be doing that today. And I'm gonna go do some laundry, cause I gotta go do my laundry. And also, these are all my like snacks right here. Like this is like what helps me kind of cut, cause I'm not really getting cut right now. I'm just kind of maintaining and kind of lean. But yeah, so we have rice cakes, peanut butter, Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Lucky Charms, pistachios, which I ran out of, banana chips, which I ran out of, almonds, there's some candy up there that I tried to not eat so much, and then I have mustard, because I usually like to eat a lot of things with mustard, because it's zero calories, and it also just tastes really good. There's Truvia, my mom got me some Truvia, and sweet potatoes, because those are some good carbs. I have egg whites, and then I have egg whites, diet cranberry juice, here's some Liposide IR, which is just a fat burner, but it's not mine. We got kiwi, which is a super fruit. We got lemons and these kombuchas that I really like drinking. Got my books right there. That's pretty much it. But yeah, I'm gonna go do the laundry because I need workout clothes, get dressed, call my grandma, and go hit the workout and video that for y'all early. Record whatever you fucking, I don't know what you call it, but yeah, just record it. Alright, see you later. Heading to the gym soon. I just wanted to point out what I eat. Not all the time, but most of the time, my pre-workout will either be rice cakes with peanut butter on top, or some oatmeal with some peanut butter in it. And I don't really have any sweetener. Like I ran all out of stevia. So I'll probably do oatmeal with some peanut butter, and I had something, I don't know what I was doing, something else to sweeten it, I don't know what it was, but I'm forgetting right now. Oh, I think I might throw protein powder in there. I think that was a big thing to sweeten it up. But yeah, having this, and then gonna go get the laundry, take my pre-workout, wait about 20 minutes for it to kick in, and head out to the gym and start recording for y'all. My favorite song to squat to. Right here.
Yeah. I pull up roto windows, honey.
Alright, anyways.
I pull up roto windows.
Let's go work out.
Yeah. I pull up roto window down.
Yeah. Alright, so this is my first time doing a voiceover, so sorry if it's a little bit monotone. I'm just gonna describe what I did for this workout today. So as you can see, I started off with close grip bench, had a reverse grip on it. I did four sets, two sets with 135 and two sets with 155. After this, I went and did skull crushers. I don't really necessarily like going heavy on skull crushers. I like feeling the stretch, so I go a lot lighter, feel it stretch on my muscle, and then extended flex. I usually do four sets of everything, two warm up and then two working. When you do skull crushers, you don't need to go up and wait for working. It's really based off of how hard you kind of connect to your muscles or make them work. After skull crushers, I went to do this workout that I do, or a friend showed it to me. You do seven, it's kind of like 21s but for triceps, and in this video I did another variation of it. I kind of did 35s, if you want to like say, I guess, because I did two lower partials, two upper partials, and then a third full rep. After that, I turned in my elbows to do another variation, and then I did another one. It was even a closer grip, and it was really focused on stretching the tricep out. After that, I think I didn't cut my workout short. I just had a really good pump today. I did four sets of that also, and then I moved to tricep extensions, single arm, because I feel like you can really focus on what part of the tricep you're hitting, because hear it in the name, there's three parts of it, and it all depends on where you pressurize your grips. So if you're focusing on squeezing your two, your index and your ring finger, then it's gonna work the more inside, I would say. And then outside, you're gonna be focusing on your pinky. If you're squeezing your pinky really hard, it's gonna hit a different part of the tricep. So yeah, that's a run through of what I did today. So I'll let y'all enjoy this video now, with some nice, actually I'm just gonna put music that I listen to on it, like the music that I listen to while I work out today.
Hey yo, Nicky Jam, Ozuna, Post Malone, Spanish Remix,
Trap Star. Woo!
Hago lo que quiera, compro lo que quiera, porque soy un rockstar. Voy para el avión privado en el Ferrari, en el tablero 180. Voy de camino a Suiza para lanzar mi propio juglo a la venta. Y voy llamando al ruso porque quiero gastarme un millón en prenda.
Una Panamera, un F12 frente a casa. Gucci, Ferragamo, compro todo plaza. Rino, palo, corta, rata que te casa. Miles de hipócritas que vienen y te abrazan. Yeah, yeah, vivo la vida como un rey. Kilos de música de Medellín a Monterrey. Siempre cruzando todos los límites de la ley. Mi movie siempre está en play.